由香港中文大学人间佛教研究中心主办的讲座。今天中心很高兴邀请到几博士为我们主讲 Water and Fauna and Buddhism。现在讲座马上开始，请大家把手机电话调至静音模式，谢谢大家的配合。现在有请中心主任陈建华教授为我们介绍讲解，请陈教授。
今天我们这个讲座是用我们 Dr. Bennett 是使用英文来讲演，因为他说他在海外居住了25年吧，那么回中国，他是中国天津的出生的，但是一直在澳洲20几年都没有回到中国，那平时也都是用英文来交谈，所以他希望他可以用英文来讲演，他方便一点。但是待会我们的 Q&A 大家也可以用中文来跟他提问的，他中文是可以讲，只是说他说啊他自己中文没那么流利，因为有时候词他会忘词。那他是澳洲雪梨大学的水文学的博士，那么是水文学，就这个水文学大家听得懂吗？水文学这方面的博士，那最主要就是做水的研究。那他也是一个很虔诚的佛教徒，自己也很有实修，做一些 practice。因此他就把他的所学跟他的信仰结合在一起，才有今天我们这一个讲题，就是这个 water environment and Buddhism。当然，这是 disciplinary 的一个跨学科的一个。讨论这个其实是不容易的，他有很多的见解，包括他会给我们一些关于我们水资源运用的情况，我们今天我们人类怎么样去浪费，或是怎么样的去，应该就是说我们在浪费这个水资源，然后我们怎么样去了解整个全球水资源的分布的情况，然后接着我们要怎么样用佛法。我们讲的时候，他说要 practice the Buddha's teaching， 要过戒的生活。我们要怎么样？要这个有一个 content 的 life， 所以我们才可以有一个比较快乐幸福的生活。那总而言之，我们人总是贪嗔痴嘛，我们要的不多，需要的不多了。但是我们要的都很多，对不对？所以我们应该去 pursue the what we really need， what we want is unimportant， 应该是这么说的。我们其实都在追求一些我们真的不是需要的东西，但是我们内心那个 desire 那个要的那个欲望很强。我想今天这个议题就是要 combine 在一起，在这里。最后他会告诉我们怎么样来把我们那种欲望，比如说用水资源这种欲望怎么样去克服，那用佛法的方式来做，这是他今天要跟我们讲。但我刚才只是介绍说他是雪梨大学的水文学的博士，那么他接着也留在这个雪梨大学做研究员，然后现在他现在的工作是在一个这个叫做什么工作Universal Solar Service， 它最主要是在负责整个课程的规划，就是一个很世界性机构的一个教育团体，它的机构是全世界性的，所以它常常跑美国、跑加拿大等等各地去上课。那最主要，他说他是 main responsibility include upgrading the education system to the global university standard， 他最主要是做这个工作。那总而言之，他是很难的一个人。昨天又飞机 delay 从澳洲飞过来，delay 了3个小时，到了我们中大的这个宾馆已经9点多了。那澳洲跟我们香港也有时差3个小时，对不对？所以他今天跟我说，早上5点就起床了，有一点点就累吧。好，那我想应该也没什么问题。他常常世界这样子啊，澳洲飞过来是8、9个小时，对他来讲的这个 travel time 是非常的高， 不像到成龙总统，他说要飞40个小时，怎么4小时在外面？所以我想今天他应该会有很充足的精神来跟我们做这样的讲。我们最热烈的掌声来欢迎他。
I start my presentation, I want to talk about a little bit of science and the religions. Science and the religion is historically have impact on, they have the harmony and conflict. These two very powerful forces have shaped human civilizations. So they will continue to interact our daily lives. So the both dealing with, they are dealing with our different realm of the human experience. The science is investigates the natural world. Then the religions is dealing with the spiritual and the supernatural. So then, although today we have about 84% of the world the populations, they have the faith. They belong to different religious groups, which including 10% of Buddhists. And many, many scientists, they are so busy to do their scientific research. In the meantime, they keep their personal belief, spiritual belief. But these two is never still separate. The religions still keep in the personal theme, and the educations like science and the religions, this course still limited in the faculty of the theology and the religions at the universities. It means it's not in the mainstream. 就是说这个神学院 science 和 religion 只是限制在神学院里面的课程， 还没有被普遍接受。 Currently, we experience very severe ecological the problem and the crisis. That's directly resulted by this separation, because one hand is fast developing technology, another hand is lost the ethical and moral values. So that's the crisis. Is the scientists cannot not able to deal by themselves anymore. So that's the time science and the religion should work together as one. Otherwise, science is just knowledge, and religion is just a teaching of one kind of teaching of many. It's the both. There's no meaning for improving human life. Fortunately, there are many scientists and spiritual leaders are acting. For example, many scientific research, they are being carried out in the neuroscience, mental health, philosophy and psychology. Then in our Buddhist realm, society, there have a vulnerable bhikkhu body. He's the founder of the director of the Buddhist Global Relief. He's addressed climate change and the related issue at the gathering of Buddhists on the White House, at the White House in May 2015. Then the 14th, the Dalai Lama held the conference on the quantum physics and muddy Mecca, the philosophers in India in November 2015, then the 17th Kamapa, that's the second one is Dalai Lama, I think everyone knows the Dalai Lama. The third one is 十七世大宝方, it's talk about environmental issues in Europe last year. So here today in my presentation will bring the water, environment and the Buddhism together. I'm trying to use the Buddhist wisdom to diagnose the real root of the cause of this crisis. Then we trying to find the secular solutions, use Buddhism. That's, I'm here just cast a break to attract the day. That's Paul joining in, trying to get everyone's intelligent ideas, open your mind a little bit. So how can we fix this problem? Especially here, it's lots of young people here. I think you maybe open up your future study too. Today's my presentation. There are three parts. First one is the nature of the water. It's about water science. A lot of numbers in there. And the second one is water and related environment issues. Then third one is I'm trying to talk about the solutions from the Buddhism. I want to ask you, who's studying, who's a water and environmental professional here? Anyone? Oh, I'm the only one, so I don't need to worry about it. I'm not nervous anymore, okay. Who is a Buddhist? Interesting part. Wow. So, you are the Buddhist, then you can sleep through my most third part, okay? So, because you know better than me. So, part one, nature of the water. Water is life. It's including two aspects, physical and spiritual. Then water on earth, water cycle movement, and the fresh water usage. Usage effect. Water is life. Water is blood. It is life for the human and for another 1 trillion other life forms. So, our biologically, our human body have 70% water. So, we can survive several weeks without food, but we only can survive several days without water. So then the water is a resource to produce food, clothes, and a healthy environment to us too. So water also uses a spiritual purpose. So it's about symbolize wisdom. You know, if you study the pure land, you know, the 八功德水, 水池, the pool, and purify the 浴佛节, which is doing the 浴佛, this means purifying, and the blessings from a Guanyin, use the vital. Normally, we are in the temple, we have those ceremonies. Then offering to cultivate virtues. This Tibetan If you practice Tibetan Buddhists, you know that they offering the Buddha, the statue, the seven bowls of water. That's a real a reality. Water on Earth. The Earth cover about 71% water. So, the pie chart is only the small 2.5% is fresh water, and the other part is in the ocean or in the inland saline water, inland, you know, the salty lake or something. Then on the right, that's the pie chart is about in this 2.5%, there is the orange color, dark orange color, it's 68.5%. This is the water locked in the, this permanent ice and snow locked in the mountains, then in the polar area, like Antarctica and Arctic area. So that's not available. Then there is the gray area, is groundwater. It's about 30.1%, and that's 2.5%. Then the little bit underneath, it's 1.2% is the water in the lake and the rivers. So in the total, we only get 0.007% the water is accessible. So humans only use that little tiny water to for sustain 7.3 billion the people and the other living beings on the earth. This number 1.75% is in the total is 7%. You can say the different percentage. Water cycle movement. The water in on the earth, the moving in that circles. This is a physical process from evaporation over there nearby the sun, then from the ocean, from the land, and from the vegetations. They evaporate to the air, into the air. Then condensation, they ningu. Then the precipitation is the rainfall. The dots, this 凝固以后会下雨, 然后是 infiltration. Infiltration is the water come down from the tree. They call infiltration. And the surface run off, water running off from the surface, from 地面流走. And the subsurface floor is 渗到地下, 然后从地下 流走. 我尽量能用中文的时候 会让大家 讲一下, 因为 这个是 science 方面. That circle can, it can be expressed like an equation. So on the left it's rainfall, then each part plus together, that's the circle that keep the balance about our, to keep the certain amount of the fresh water. that's about 10.22 million cubic kilometers. That's the total water we have in this circle. Normally we can have on the Earth, but that's uneven distributed geographically. Somewhere got lots of water, like Canada, they have heaps of water, but other area, almost none, very few, like Africa. So, climate change, this impact on this circle, they will change the balance, they change some part really big, than without other parts. So that's why on the TV we have a lot of severe weathers, storms, and the drought, and the bushfire. It's about that circle lost the balance. Because they say it's changed the weather pattern. Let's say some of fresh water usage effect. Who uses this fresh water? Globally, agriculture uses 70% the water, mainly use irrigation. The second one is industry. They use 20% use hydropower generation, generate the energy, and cooling water. Some factory, they doing a cooling process, and the bigger part is hydro power generation. They use lots of water to do the cooling too. And the process water, when the industry, they have make a products, they use water during the process. And the products of water, that's the food. Like we eat the canned food, some food with the water. As a medium for the waste water, disposal, you know, the factory trying to get the waste out, and they use water to wash them up. Domestically, that's 10%. We use at the home, it's about mainly use drinking, cooking, washing, and sanitation, and take a shower or keep a hygiene. That's the part two, water and relate the environment issues. Here, I'm going to talk two big issues in the water and the environment. The first one is fresh water scarcity. It's a shortage. It's about the quantity issues. Then next one is the fresh water pollution. It's about the quality issues. Then I'm talking about the solutions from scientists. What they doing right now, trying to fix those problems. So this. The data from the World Business Council for Sustainable Development, that is the United Nations Water Agency. Here I'm using lots of, you know, the source, the data all come from UN Water. It's the official one. If you're interested, you can write down this link, you can check it out. Or if you want to do some similar teaching, I suggest that this is the reliable the data source. Freshwater scarcity. According to the WHO and the UNI, say 2014, the WHO is a World Health Organization. UNICEF, the United Nations International Children's Emergency Fund. That's 2014. 1.8 billion people lack of safe drinking water. It's 2.4 billion people lack of sanitation. It's not hygiene. Then 3,900 children died each day. That's each day from the dirty water or poor hygiene. 1.8 million people die every year from diarrhea. It's from the poor hygiene most of the time, or drink the dirty water. 4 billion people facing severe water scarcity. It's very bad. It's mainly from India and China. That's from the journal Science Advance 2016. This is a scientific journal, 2016年, that's the pretty new the data. This is global water stress the map. That's from the International Water Management Institute. That's the 2006 the data. This organization is another United Nations the Water Agency. So why is 2006? Because the United Nations and lots of top scientific journals, normally they charge you to get the data, but after a while they will release for free. That's why it's right now it's free. So it's a bit old. We can say the dark red colors, that's, that area means the water is not enough for the demand. They not meet the people's needs. That's the water shortage area. Then the orange color, it means approach that level right now. So in the green yellow color is the economic water shortage. That means there is no the technology can build the infrastructure to get the water out, or there the water too expensive, the people cannot afford it to use them. So the blue color, it means no problem. Fresh water scarcity in China. So there's some numbers over there. In China, there's 20% of the world's the population there. But we only got 7% of the world fresh water. 30% lakes and the rivers are unfit for human use. 73% of the watersheds supply water to 30 fast growing cities. So with water shortage in China, it's mainly in northern China. So we can say from this the map, the red color is means water shortage, you can see. That one is extremely high, that's 80% the shortage. Then the light dark color is 40 to 80%, and the orange color is medium. So we can see how bad the situation over there. So this is the map and the data from the World Resources Institute 2016. That's all latest data. The major reasons why we have these problems. First one is the fresh water resources is limited. before we talk about, you know, I mentioned that only 0.007% we can get it the by our current technology. And this highly uneven distributed. Another reason is overdraw groundwaters. Groundwater is needed long term to recovery. Some groundwater need a million years, even the deeper one. So the, sometimes the dinosaur, the water just from the dinosaur age. So when we use them, get them out, it's not enough time to let them recover. But many countries, they use, mostly agriculture, they use the groundwater. Like UK, United Kingdom, they use 90%. The irrigation water, they use from ground. So populations grows and the global trading, because the population grows, they need food, more water, more energy. The food need more water, energy need more water. It's not just simply it's one number of the water. Fresh water, then finally collapse of fresh water pollutions from agriculture, industry, and human activities. Right now, I talk about the pollution, this water quantity issues. This mainly is a contamination about rivers, lakes, and the groundwater. So this is from agriculture from the fertilizer, the failure. Pesticide, 农药, livestock manures, the 牲畜的 粪便, industrial pollution, it's industrial chemical and waste, 那些化学的 废料, mining. When you drilling, you just normally when you have the aquifer, 就是含水层, 一层, 上面的一层, the top one, it's mostly very easy to be polluted. Then when they doing mining, they drilling through, then it's top of the polluted water being connected to the bottom layer. So they contaminate all the layers. So that's the bigger problem right now. And the acid really caused by air pollution. When this the air being polluted, the wall, that's another pollution. And the petroleum leaking, 原油泄漏, it's 400,000 tanks leaking reported to EPA America in 2001. It's only 1 year. They have 400,000 report 这么多。 Human activities 就是 fecal waste sewage 就是 人类的那些排泄 Water pollution in China, that's the number 33 industrial waste water, and 90% household sewage, they are untreated to release the river. 这些都没经过处理，直接进到河流里面。 80% of city, this is 278 cities, have no sewage treatment facility. There the sewage is the those city without 没有废叫什么废物处理，直接放就是流放到河里。70% river lakes and waterways seriously polluted. It's 980 million people partially, and 600 million people drink the water. Drink the water contaminated with human or animal waste. Those people just drinking the dirty water.So this source from a different Chinese government resource, then lots of numbers. But this number is much lower than, I think, more conservative than the real number. 因为这个是中国政府的数字，我个人的经验，它会很低于实际的数字，它不因为他政治的目的政治上的目的。
The fresh water scarcity by 2050, the population and the urbanization increase, the population will increase to 9.3 billion people. But right now it's 7.3, it's another 2 billion.And 2 million a day from 2010 to 2015, that's the speed the people move into the city. The people living in the city, they consume water about more than 3 times. So that's the water will increasing.The agriculture water consumption will increase 17%, which already kick off the technology improvement, like 用很高的技术做 irrigation 中文怎么说？做灌溉啊，就是更有效的灌溉方法啊，然后。就是 fix the pipe, leaking pipe, 就是把那些漏水的 pipe, 这些所有的这些数字都已经减掉了，然后还要增加17%。Industrial use will increase 20%. Climate change caused rain dependent agriculture down by 50%.That means, 我们现在可以有一半的庄稼可以用下雨来生长，但是到那个时候会有一半消失的。Plus pollution from above human agriculture and industrial, they pollute the water and reduce the fresh water we use. That's the project water scarcity in 2025. So this source is the same from the last the organization doing this one. So I put the small the mic in 2016 there. You can compare it. So,From this map, you can see the bottom part all turn to yellow or there's no blue left anymore. So we can say in China, there's nothing blue. It's almost half. It's very, very severe, the water shortage, and the bottom, it's almost there too.Fresh water scarcity in China by 2050. I don't know why I put the question marks there. I don't know how to write this slide. I don't know how bad they're going to be. Only I give all my best wishes over there. So solution from a scientist. Scientists working tirelessly trying to find the solution to fix this problem. So the first one is water integrity management. They try to manage the major river together, like Blue Nile in Europe. They're crossing so many countries. They're trying to take over to manage it to say, use more effectively, like a Mekong River in Vietnam or this area. Right now, I think they're working on the Yangtze River, Changjiang, Lianhe Guo的那个 water 机构, 投资啊, 在, 想把长江的问题解决掉。And the water footprint, it means this is data. Calculate each part, how much you use your water, you drink water, or you doing this, how much water you use, you eat this, how much water you use, then calculate it. Then you have the ideas of how much water you consume, then, so you can say the use green water for irrigation. That's green water means some clean-based water, relatively clean, from the bath, the sinks, washing machines, and trying to save that water, collect that water to do the irrigation.
Desalination, that is, 这个就是用海水淡，海水淡化。Rainwater harvest, 收集雨水啊，然后 waste water treatment, recycling.It means from the sewage, 就是那个废是叫废物排放，就是 human 的那个 toilet 的那个从厕所里排出的那个水，直接就进到那个收集起来，进到那个污水处理厂，然后处理完之后再放回我们的用水的那里，所以。这一个最大的最成功的是 Singapore， 所以你要是去新加坡的话，你喝的那个水是从你厕所里出来的。The community, you know, a lot of the non-profit, you know, they on the organizations, they try to let people to, you know, shower, shower or do not bother garden or.Save this very tiny actually. Sounds, you know, it's a bigger movement, actually very tiny. It's the possibility to fix the problem, that's it, save. So I broke down in this graph, the truth of the freshwater reality.This, when we say, have a look at the, on the left hand, the water resource, that's the come down. The other side, the demand go other way, the plus pollution and the climate change. So this going apart, they never can be the equation. So that means we never can fix this problem.So this is the sum of, I've broken down to this table. You can see what the scientists, the work, what they can do. And they're doing water resource, they're doing a heaps of research, the climate change data, reduce the pollution. They are doing the,have done a great job. There's not much room to improve anymore. So on the other side, the demanding, it's clearly, that's government's job. So it's about
population growth, economic system, global food products trading, and the human overall consumption. It's the government, the policy, and the system. See, they should make the policy and the system to reduce the overall consumption. It's about this one, to trigger the right side, reduce the diet pack. Because at the moment, we are doing that is encouraging, the system is encouraging people to buy more products, to do more global trading, then it's just opposite. How can we do this? Let's need to change our mindset and behavior to reduce the demanding. That's, I talk a lot about the reality. That's the reality. That's the scientists doing. That's we doing. Someone like me doing like this. So, part three, that's the part belong to you, you guys. There are solutions from the Buddhism. Here I talk three parts. First is Buddhist teaching, including three parts of the concept of the nature. And the second one is the concept of suffering. In this part, I use the Four Noble Truths, that's Si Sheng Di. The third part, the way to stop suffering. Let's call threefold partition. San xue is jie ding hui. The eightfold path, the ba gen dao. The second part is diagnose the root causes of that fresh water crisis. Three Buddhist the wisdom. Then last part, the solution from the Buddhist, then how we change the mindset and the behaviors to reduce the consumptions at all levels, from the individual and the collectives, from a 个人到集体. Buddhist teaching is the first one, Buddhist concept of nature. The ultimate nature is emptiness. Buddhist 讲空吧，讲空. Emptiness is not mean the nothingness. It means everything existed by each other. It's not just one thing. It's nothing you can exist independently. 就是说，每一个人。 都不可以独立存在，你这个人生活在这个世界上，你每一个每一秒每一刻，你都是在用 environment 还是用其他的人的依靠他人 ，environment inhabitant and inhabitants are composed of same basic elements: earth, wind, fire, water, and space。 就是我们的周围的环境和我们的人都是用同样的元素组成的，都是这些，地啊、水火风啊、寒、space，所以本质上来说，我们都是一样的，都是一个整体。Interdependence or interrelationships。 For the environment and the inhabitants, the environment and all living things, we are all connected. This teaching is basically say environment and all living things are the one. We are just 我们是一个整体，是分不开的。 Buddhist concept of suffering, Four Noble Truths, 四圣谛. That is is the first teaching of the Buddha, Shikamuni Buddha, after enlightenment. That's his first teaching. Suffering, the first noble truth. 第一个圣谛啊，叫 suffering of pain, 那叫苦。然后呢，there are three levels sufferings, 不同之的三个级别的苦。第一个 suffering of pain is physical, 叫苦苦 physically or mentally we can experience. This is the real pain. So this is the first level. Second level is the suffering of change called 坏苦. That's the suffering is the temporary pleasure. In this, 这个这在这一个级别的时候，是你有快乐，正在快乐。你的痛苦是想保持这个快乐，但是任何事情都是在变化，你没有办法保持这个快乐，所以这个是个苦的。The suffering for keeping your pleasure. 但是这个苦过了那个 pleasure, 它又会降到那个苦苦，会降到那个最底层的苦苦。然后 third level 是 pervasive suffering, 这叫行苦或者是舍受，就是说不苦不乐。前面那个是第一个是苦，然后呢第二个是乐，然后这个级别是不苦不乐，你感觉不到苦，没有感觉，就是现在的话有时候你感觉不到，感觉不到是因为什么？是因为你的智慧不到，因为我们人的智慧有限，我们只能看到这一个 moment, 现在我们看不到下一个秒钟或者是下一天下一年会发生什么，所以呢这一个在这一别的苦只有很多的时候只有被那些已经 enlightened 的大师们能够看到，因为他比如说像阿罗汉他可以看到五百世，所以呢有些苦他会咱们看不到，他会看到，因为五百世嘛。那只有佛陀能够看到所有的因缘嘛。但是这一个最后会有可能变成pleasure, 也可能直接就到了从 pleasure 然后到了苦苦，或者也有可能一下子就变到那个苦苦，所以这是三级的苦。第二个noble truth 就是圣谛呀，就是 cause of suffering, 怎么这些 suffering 是怎么引起来的。 The three poisons 就是贪嗔痴，我们的贪嗔痴引起来，贪就是 attachment, greed, endless desire, physically and mentally. So this result, suffering of change and the suffering of pain. 就是说这个贪呢可以，因为我们有不断的没有 limited 的那个欲望，那它可以引起前两个那个痛苦，一个苦苦，一个那个 change, 就是那个暂时的快乐的那个苦。然后是嗔，就是aversion, hatred, ill wills and malicious, 这个是 suffering pain, 就是直接就走到了那个最底层的那个苦，因为当 你的你的精神和你的身体都是在受苦。The third one, delusion and ignorance, that's the 痴 that's the lack of the wisdom. 这一个会引起前面三个苦，因为如果你没有 wisdom, 它会引起那个前面三个苦。
这个第三个圣谛就是 cessation of suffering, 我们怎么样Stop this pain. Threefold partitions,
就是三学啊，那个戒定慧。我们怎么样？那个戒是对着那个贪。Anyone, 你们，我要是说 ，anyone knows, doesn't understand Chinese? You, the gentleman, do you understand Chinese?Oh, okay, that's great. So, 这里所以我可以解释一下用中文，免得谁的英语谁不懂的话会漏掉。
这里的话就是说那个戒你是要戒贪的，是跟贪是对的，所以你要用 virtues，
你要积累功德啊，你要 generosity， 你要给啊，要舍啊，用那个舍去止贪嘛。
然后第二个是 mind， loving kindness 是定，这个是指你的真的。
为什么？当你有愤怒的时候，你 hatred， 你要 calm down， 你要从定里面出智慧，你会有那个 loving kindness。
然后是第三个是
wisdom。这个为什么？当然这个容易了，就是说你没有智慧的话，吃的话，那当然你就得要用 wisdom 来用智慧来对治了。
最后一个就是 the path leading to cessation of suffering，
那个我们可以find a way to
怎么样才可以停，就是停止这个 suffering 啊，就是 the 八正道啊 ，eightfold 的八正道 ，the way to stop suffering， threefold partition and eightfold path， 这个 table 呢，
就是我在讲。因为这个三学和八正道呢是一体的，
这个八正道就是告诉你更详细一样，你怎么去做，就是做到行动上。所以你可以看到那个戒呢 ，virtual generosity 呢，就是说你的行动和言行，那是 right speech， right action， right livelihood， 就是你要说
正确的人啊，正确的行业啊，正确的
你们可以读那个中文的。然后那个 mind 这个定啊，就是说 right effort， right mindfulness and right concentration， 然后是这个 wisdom 慧啊，就是 right view， right intention，
这个是其实这两个是一体的，所以你就可以用这一个表可以修行了。Diagnose this the water crisis， use 这个四圣谛啊和这个八道四圣谛的那个第一个圣谛啊，这个左边呢是 water crisis， 是现在我们面对的问题，然后右面呢就是说这个是什么样的苦，然后我们可 可以找到相对的就是解决的办法。所以这个 fresh water shortage 和 pollution 就是说我们缺水的那个问题和 pollution 我们已经亲身体会到了，所以我们现在都已经感觉到了那个痛苦，所以它是苦苦。这个苦苦因为我们都已经感觉到了，每个人都已经知道了，所以呢这一个部分呢其实是最容易，因为大家知道了以后，他受了痛苦之后，他自己会想办法来改进。所以这一个部分的话其实虽然很难过，但是呢这个部分就是比较容易。最难的是这个第二个部分 economic system global trading over consuming and the boundary selflessness。 这是第二个坏，就是因为它有 temporary pleasure， 它当它有利益的时候，这个是破坏性最大的，在这里，因为他会追求更多的利益，这个贪会更贪。如果他贪不到的话，他就会有嗔，所以他嗔的时候，他就会伤害其他的伤害环境和其他的人的利益。所以这个第二个部分是非常非常我们应该重点的。然后第三个部分就是 climate change， 那个就是英文叫刑苦。因为你比如说 climate change 现在的话，两个极地的冰融化，你比如说北极的冰现在在50年的话，它已经变成了它已经丢失到了60%到很，就是说如果它这个冰融化以后，它的这个地面反射的热量很多嘛，它就会地球的温度就会升高嘛。所以但是的国家住在像美国像我们住在中间的人，这些国家领导这些人的话，我们看不到，我们感觉不到那个痛苦，那是跟我们有任何什么关系啊？我照样这里很好，所以他看不到这个 suffering in the future。 就像我刚才说的那些开悟的大师，他能看很多事，所以他能看得到，但是我们的人看不到。当我们看到的时候，这就太晚了。我个人我在澳洲的时候，在悉尼大学，我做的研究是 computer modeling future climate change how to impact on the water， 就是说我做的电脑模型要模型2041年到2060年这20年间澳洲的水资源的情况。当我做这个的时候，其实我很痛苦，因为有时候一个月都没有水啊。然后我学到了很多的那个 future climate change 的，因为我要用它做模型嘛，我就要学很多的东西。然后最残酷的一个事实就是说，如果我们现在人类全部就是 stop 什么都不做，就是说我们现在全都停止，那这个地球的温度在100年之内还要升2度，就是我们现在什么都不再做，这温度在这100年之内还要升2度。这个2度的结果是什么？这个2度的结果的海洋会增加1米，就是海的平面会升高1米，这个1米会丢失多少
人的居住的地方，很多的地方都已经国土就会少很多的 land， 那些 Pacific Island 会很多的国家都会在海底，像瓦努阿图，它只有1米左右在水面，那它用不了50年就全部进到就是在了海底，所以有时候做起算一次来也不容易，好像这也是可能推着我去学来学佛的原因。Here 我想谈一下 boundary selfishness。 我们一提起来自私，就是说你和我还有他，为了我们自己的利益，然后大家会 point finger， 哦，你很自私。但是当我们这个人做这个利益给你的家庭，给你的学校，给你的大学，给你的团体，给你的公司，给你的国家的时候，这个人会变成什么？会变成 hero。 但是最主要的问题是什么？我们一个人的自私，他的伤害很小，一个人你再厉害也伤害不了太多，但是如果是这个团体，那伤害力非常非常的大，非常 dangerous。 所以你看那个战争和这些战争都是我要为我国家的利益来打仗，然后我要为我的公司，为我的家庭，所以这个我们看不到，这是另外的一种自私，因这个非常非常的危险。所以我这个个人的经验哈，我在这里说，但是所以那个小刘小姐说要把我的放到网上，我都挺 worried， 如果我的教授看到了会骂我，这是我自己的亲身体会啊。当时我在大学里面呢做研究，我做的研究呢就是政府给的研究基金嘛，因为我们大学都有基金了，过来不同的基金。我的基金呢是从政府来，政府说你来这个基金的目的就是说你要研究澳洲北部那些cotton farm， 就是种棉花的那些农民，因为他们种棉花要用很多的水，所以他说你要做，他用多少水，因为澳洲很缺水嘛然后呢就是那个 pollution 从你的那些化肥呀、农药啊那些流失到海里，因为它和那个 Great Barrier Reef 在那里，所以现在那个 reef 的话，那些 coral coral 怎么说那珊瑚啊都在死掉啊，就是因为这些化肥流进去以后它有那个营养，然后那些吃珊瑚的那些海里的动物长得非常的快，所以就是破坏了。那就是我的研究基金就是这个要给政府提供这个依据，政府看了依据之后呢要改变政策嘛是限制农民还是怎么样。然后和我系里的另外一个 lab， 那是就是一个另外一个教授他是搞化学的嘛，他的基金呢来自就是这个 farm 的因为澳洲很多的大的 farm organization 是从他们那来的，他们很有钱啊，一拿就是几个 million。然后他们做的时候，那些 farm 就是说让你来做这个研究，然后呢看看尽量给我减少那个可能性嘛，就是政府不要有政策来让我们就是说 farm 不种棉花嘛。所以当我们 个研究的时候，我当时真的心里很难过，因为我来做就是说实实在在的来做嘛，而且那已经有证据，是电视啊哪里都是每天在报那个珊瑚啊，那个鱼类都死掉，非常严重。那这边呢，那系里面记得那教授嘛，就是说那个几个密林，那当然可以养活很多的那个 staff， 对不对？所以，他就是 hero， 他就是我们系里的 hero， 因为他的钱呢，那就是在养活这个系，对不对？所以呢，但是这个就有一个 ethic， 有个 moral， 就是一个道德问题在里面嘛。所以我现在说的就是这个问题，所以就说这个 selfishness， 就是这个自私的，就是我们应该改变这个观念。然后这个就是右面呢，就是 solution， 就是那个 Buddhist 的 solution， 就是说这些问题有了苦，那你就要用戒嘛。那你有了坏苦，那你就要用定。那有了行苦，你要用慧。那我下面呢会一个一个来讲啊。这个就是慧。我为什么讲慧？先讲慧呢？但是如果你要是中国来说，就是他界定慧在最后嘛。但是the Theravada 就是小上部座，就是小乘啊，我们一般不小乘有点贬义了，他们的话都会把慧放在前边。因为我这里的话，我个人在想，你要修行，你要改变任何事情，你要有智慧啊，先有智慧再改。但是好像我后来又在想，中国那个佛教也有道理，就是说我们没有智慧，那我们就先强迫自己，做好的，就是不伤害他人嘛，然后慢慢积累功德，然后最后也有智慧，其实也有道理，对不对？但是我现在呢，我先讲的慧，这慧在这里就是right will and right intention。我这个已经在前面，我最开始已经讲过了，就是说这个慧，我们的 science and religion 要一起，要 work together， 这个是science 给 information 的它的答案。然后呢religion 呢 teach people， influence the people， influence their heart, soul and the spirit。 Then like this crisis, we are not denial anymore, because right now the government, like some of Australia and America, they just simply deny there is no climate change, but because that's 没有智慧嘛，因为是，对不对？然后用这个智慧 to recognize the water crisis and the environment issues。Then we think in other countries, other people, the suffering. 因为我们现在在这里，我们没有问题。但是如果我们现在想到这些在中国啊，在印度啊，在 Africa 那些人，如果我们想到他们在受这些影响的时候，就是身处他们的境界来想嘛，对不对？这就是要有智慧嘛。没有智慧的时候，就觉得不关自己的事情。然后这个是定，就是说我们的desire is infinite， 我们的欲望是没有止境的。你看那些global corporation 有多少钱？也从来不会满足，我们从来都不会 never be satisfied。 So we have to reduce desire the satisfaction is very typical corporate greed. But right now, because of the global corporations and companies, they just try to get all of profit from the different countries. They're really, really powerful and damaging. Then second one is identify what is your need, what is your want individually. I want to talk about that here to change the mindset and the culture. Here, I remember last night, Professor Chin asked me why I'm doing writing the calligraphy. I talk about essay because I'm so stressed about my work. I try to calm my mind because before I just use the shopping. Then when I get stressed, I didn't know, I didn't realize. I just went to shop to get clothes, get jewelry, everything. Until the one day, it's a couple of years ago, I go to the dress, a very expensive dress. It's exactly the two of them identical. Then I stand in front of my wardrobe, 就是两件的衣服啊，一模一样。我那一件都没穿过，在我的衣柜里。然后我站在那儿，我才真正明白我的问题不是那个买东西给我的快乐，是因为我就是想让我自己，我有 stress， 我自己不明白。所以我用我自己的例子，这个非常非常的重要。 What is with our need and what is we want? Most of the time we just want this, want this, want this, and then holding, then start up. So here we have to change the mindset and the culture. The last one is a virtual. So this is about how can we, that's the fuku, this where, how can we fix the problem right now? So from executive powers, we have to do, the government have to change the system and the policy. Then from the people's power, we need to change our lifestyle and the government. I mean, if the government, the politician, they understand this, we are lucky, they will, you know, we have more benefit. But if not, if everyone of us understand this, we can vote them out. So that's the power. So this is the main point, is to change the way of living, stop overconsumption. That's the both way from the government system and the individual. As a Buddhist, we cannot avoid to talk about not killing to be a vegetarian. That's why I put this slide here. I want to you guys know how much water be used to produce 1 kilo meat and 1 kilo vegetables. It's the real hard data. That's the real one from a scientist. So this source from the Water Footprint Network. This the organization. Located in the Netherlands. There's another United Nations Water Agency. They are calculated the water efficiency, and they have a two-part program. It's one is technical, another is policy. If you have any, I suggest you guys write down this link or the name to search it, because it's very useful. Everything you're doing, you can find the how much water you use. It's not just you drink a glass of milk here. If your milk shifted from other area, they have cost extra water too. So, let me say, okay? If you eat 1 kilo of beef, that's 15,400 liters of water to produce 1 kilo of meat. So, the shape of meat is a little bit lesser, the 10,400, then the pork is 5,990 liters water. Gold meat is 5,521, and chicken is a little bit lesser, the 4,325. The rice, with the shell, another one is already being milled. It's 1,670, and say the cabbage, so 1 kilo cabbage only 237 liters. So we can do a mathematics, how many times? 65 times. That's 1 kilo meat. How many kilos you eat each week, or each year, or each 10 years of your life? So that's the big numbers there. Last meat to a vegetarian, want to be converted to a vegetarian. So we say, the Charles Darwin saying, that's a scientist, the love for all living creatures is the most noble attribute of the man. Then the second one is from the Buddha. As to become a vegetarian is to step into the stream which leads to Nirvana, the Buddha. It means you one step closer to be enlightened, to be a Buddha. So we talk about the Buddha, Shijiangmuni Fu. 他有很多的佛经在讲不要 killing， 大概有30几部吧。那台湾的海涛法师呢，他集中了起来。我那天大概算一下，好像是32 to 35那个佛经里面是佛陀在讲不要杀生，所以最著名的就是。十善业，佛说十善业经是吧？所以你们要是谁有兴趣的话，你做佛学可以到网上可以查到那个海涛法师的。然后下面的呢 ，try to cut back on how much meat we eat， not just for our health and animal welfare。But you for the environment too. That's supposed to be within you and me. So the ultimate solution, you and me. We need love and compassion to each other, to our planet, and all of living beings, the sentient beings. So that's the solution. That's all I think everyone's here. You already have this compassion, the love. So this all I know. So next, I want to learn from you what you know. So thank you. So thank you.
We have 30 minutes left, so if you have any questions, you can ask me. I think Dr. Bennett has shown a lot of graphics about the water, water, got stress to go to shopping, he just told me. Because her husband is a banker, so he got a lot of money to shop. Go to shopping.
你可以问我，用中文问我，我尽量解释。
And she's a little nervous today. I speak it very fluent. But if you have any Buddhist question or comply with the water issue, you can text her.
Professor.Your approach is using the small vehicle. I appreciate very much your explanation of the Buddhist philosophical viewpoints towards suffering in terms of the small vehicle system. But what is your opinion towards the Mahayana Buddhism, the 大乘佛教的, in terms of household practice of Buddhism? Do you have any opinions about it?
Well, that's a great question, a very big question. Would you mind I explain this in Chinese? Or you want me to do the
test? I think in English.
English, okay. You want me to explain, I try to make sure this question, you want me to talk about Mahayana Buddhism?
Yes, yes.
Talk about my personal,I
yes,
think,
yes, yes.
Not related, that's...
If related to your presentation would be good. This presentation is...
Which part would you like, water or the eating meat?
Maybe a broader view is that the suffering, the crisis of our human civilization. The crisis, the present crisis of,
yeah.
of our civilization.
Okay, so...I would say that's a bigger question, so I try to I mentioned in the last part pretty much I use the Mahayana the teaching because the 四圣谛the Four Noble Truths is all of pretty much all of a branchthey use this as the teaching. So this Mahayana Buddhism use this as a practice too. So like myself, I practice use like three practice of virtual mind and wisdom too. They use my, my own experience.So, for example, I use the generosity. Here, probably I should mention it. Yeah, before I answer your questions, I want to, every year I donated lots of money from my salaries. As Professor Chen said, my husband can cover our expending. So my money, pretty much my pocket money, then I just donated. Then I work for you know, the Chinese Agriculture Academy. I'm an overseas expert. Then I never take any cent out from China.That's the money donated to the education, the, what they say, 长城教育,中国长城教育基金. So I am trying to do from my personal levels to do this. The second one is I'm doing a lot of practice personally. I try to, you know, the chanting or even doing the prostration, the tradition, you know, the Tibetan Buddhas, the big flat bow down, and they are serious exercise, I'm doing that too. So the wisdom part, I am trying to
But so, do you have opinions towards several major sutras of the Mahayana tradition, such as the Lotus Sutra, 这个妙法莲花经，还有这个地藏经，这个 Earth Store Bodhisattva， 这个Kistigapa Sutra， something like that, the major sutras of the Mahayana Buddhism.
Yeah.
May I answer this question? I think it's a bit young in his.
No, I know that. No, I can understand. Yeah. So I've been reading those sutras, but the practice, I used to practice Di Zhang Jing a little while, because in the beginning, I was several years ago, I was personally so stressed. I got my personal problem. So I started search the religions. Before, I didn't really research the practice, the Buddhism this hard. So at that point, I said, I have no choice. Then I same tried everything, and then not working. I still feel horrible. Then I said, okay. Someone say if you recite, let's chant the Di Zhang Jing 3 times, 7 times, I'm going to do it. Then they say work. I say I'm going to try. I tried twice. It worked. You know, the Di Zhang Jing, you need 2 hours, at least 2 hours to chant it. I tried twice. Each time, recite 3 times, because the Buddhism is 3 times. The 6 hours, except I went to the toilet, then I did it. But if you want me to say the experience, I don't know if it worked or not, but it really, really, I didn't know where I was. It's the same way I was happy. I don't know, I was offended or not, because dehydrated or not, because of 6 hours. So that's my personal experience. But I think it doesn't matter which one. You just choose one. Because in the Buddhist Buddha, they have 84,000 different method. Because we have 84,000 sufferings, the thoughts. So you can try each one. Then you can find the one suited for you. That's one. I can't say how can you find it. You just have to try. When you get it, you know it. Just that. So. This is my personal experience because I tried everything, tried lots of things. I haven't tried, 84,000, but I tried a lot of things. It worked. I promise you, because I have this experience. So just try one first. And here I want to say, sorry, I want to say a little bit more because. We've been teaching from the beginning, you have to learn with one master or something. Then this, my opinion is, if you are in the beginning, you have to try every branch. You cannot just get the one, because when you follow one, if that's one not right to you, you are going to be that's suffering. Because when we practice Buddhism, we want to be happy, be 去掉恶, then you are that's a hatred. That's any bad feeling is opposite. The Buddhist teaching is opposite to you on the way to be enlightened. So you have to be feel good first, then get rid of bad feeling. Then when you make a gradually, you get more wisdom, then the good disappears. Because without the bad, the good, it's not there. So that's my personal experience. I hope I answer your question.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Also, a question about from your experience. I can hear that you know you probably have a pretty stressful life in the past. So, how do you see the sources of your stress? And after you practice Buddhism, what is the turnkey? For you relieving the stress of your life.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. 更了解一下，作为一个就是分享，就是说之前你的 stress 是从哪里来的，然后你 practice 了 Buddhism 之后呢，那个关键在哪儿，让你觉得就是说，可以对你有一个帮助，然后有一个一个比较对人生方面有一个正面的一个启发。
谢谢哦，这是非常实用的一个问题啊，因为我的 stress 就是从我读博士以后，因为这个你们都是 academic 知道，读了博士以后又要博士后又要自己写那个funding， 然后呢当时澳洲的政策呢又是每天也政府卡这些 funding， 当我因为你年轻那你的竞争力会很弱嘛，所以你工作的很累很累，然后呢身体就开始也不怎么好。后来我真的个人紧张到什么程度，我住到了医院了，病毒感染了，抢救了八天，在这八天之内呢，我到了另外的世界两次。就这样的飞在天空，就跟着一模一样啊。其实当时的时候，我就是，我自己非常明白说，哦，我现在已经死掉了。那我念过佛，我要喊那个阿弥陀佛啊。当时我就在喊呢、啊，可是喊了很久都阿弥陀佛都没出来。所以因为我自己当时觉得好像在死掉嘛，所以很着急。我就说哇，那我以前梦过 Jesus 三次嘛，非常殊胜。那我就说，哎呀 ，Jesus， 你如果这个时候我向你忏悔啊，我当时你给我拖了三次到我梦里来啊，我都没跟你去，你现在带我马上跟你去。结果他也没来，然后呢？我就开始一个一个宗教，因为我以前都看过那些圣经啊，中英文的什么都看过，我就开始啊说哦那个圣母玛利亚，然后这次 Catholic， 然后又到了那个 Muslim， 这次我都不知道的时候，因为 Muslim 我不知道嘛，那我知道穆罕默德和阿里，我就说那穆罕默德阿里，我知道你很好，我不知道你，但是。你现在带我都去嘛，结果都没有可能啊。其实当时的那个焦虑哇真的很厉害，然后我也看到就是那个不同的 creature 跟着我嘛，就是那个意念上就告诉我跟我们走嘛。那我对不起，我说这个你们如果有那什么的，这是我个人的 experience 了。然后我当时就因为他从开始就跟着我到最后我就很急嘛，我在那边喊完了以后都没有人，没有任何的出来，然后我就这样的喊一句 不管了，反正，你如果是，正确的，那个 spiritual， 是正法，我就跟你去，我知道不知道，我就跟你去，你就来领我。但是如果你是邪的，那我肯定不跟你走。我这个一个念一出来，我的医生马上就说啊，他醒过来了，醒过来了。所以我从那以后的话，我为什么信心非常坚定就在这里。我当时我就在想，人的信心真的很厉害啊，如果我当时的话，那个信心是走了的话，人就已经就是那个就是我不太喜欢的 creature 的话，也就会跟他走掉。后来呢，我就和我有道教的师傅，我以前我道教我也修过，然后呢，我西藏的密宗的师傅，他们都很厉害，都有看很多事的那个经历嘛。后来我就来问他们，他们就跟我说，他说对的，就是因为你这个信念，如果没有那个信念的话，你就是另外一种情景。所以从那以后，我个人的话就开始在想，我回到这个人世间的话，我个人的the mission 是什么？其实我也很烦恼，因为看到报纸有很多的人直接他就会被告诉嘛，哎呀，你要回去干什么？我什么都不知道，所以我心里也很难过很久。但是我就是说我一定要珍惜时间的，要做这个修炼。所以从那以后的话，我就开始每一天的时候，我有时候去那个佛教的 retreat 的时候，我就会把我自己想象成我已经离开了这个世界，那我就进到他这个佛教 retreat 的时候，我就非常非常的清静，就非常的收获非常大嘛。那有很多的时候，其他的人就说为什么你明白我们不明白啊？那我就说是因为我进来的时候，我就说那个世界已经不存在了。所以我每天晚上睡觉的时候，我都会这样子告诉我，因为我有师父说要练，也有练习嘛，就是每天睡觉你都是在一个 reincarnation， 就是说你睡过去的时候，也就是你死去了，然后第二天醒过来的时候，你就是和咱们的人生一样啊，就跟你死过一次，然后又起来。所以你慢慢的这样子的话，就会转化你自己，然后你的生活也会改变，你会觉得你非常的开心，因为这个世界很多的东西你就不再在乎了。就像你举个例子，就像你已经升到另外一个 level， 就像你在看那地上的蚂蚁一样，它那个世界他们都在忙，跟你没有关系了。所以这个就是我个人的体会，因为你会非常的开心，无论是不开心的事情你也会开心。就像我昨天飞机的话三个多小时晚机啊，要很多的人非常的愤怒，你就能看到他在机场的那个愤怒的样子。所以只有然后我自己在那儿非常的开心，那没有办法，那其中有原因嘛，所以就开始受用了。就是说你不会被周围的环境来控制你，你会怎么说，你是有选择吗？你是做决定这个环境。但是我们当我们没有修炼的时候，我们会被环境左右。就是说如果我对你好你就开心，如果我是对你不好你就不开心，那就等于说你被我控制，对不对？所以 你如果你这样子练习的话，你一定会受用。但是有一点我个人的体会，你必须 consistent， 你一定要连续，你像念经一样，你要念的话，你每天相同的时间相同的地点去念。你如果今天不开心或者是有事情，你可以少念，但是绝对不能不念。如果你一不念，就像什么东西你把它卡断一样。但是你即使是念一句的话，你都会是连续的，你会是一点点的进步。这是就是我私人的
他有这么听来才知道你有濒临死亡的经验，所以一般去过了之后再回来，对于人世间的看法会不一样啊。对，所以那个信仰是很坚定，所以会很虔诚，他是一个很虔诚的佛教徒。所以他刚才讲的一个很重要的问题是，当我们是 beginner 的时候，我们不可以说马上就一门深入，他当然应该是这么说，你要接触很多的，比如说伊斯兰教等等，道教什么都要接触，比较了解，因为你要先从里面去熟悉之后，然后你才能够选定你所要走，这个才叫做一门深入。其实我们组织大的说是要选定什么了，就一句阿弥陀佛，那个是方便说的。所以真的所谓的一门深入是你要全部都了解之后，有一个判断说你选定了，那个才叫做要开始做一门深入。不是一开始人家叫我们怎么做怎么做，这个就蛮迷信。我佛法要讲自信，刚才讲那个大乘佛法，如果面对那个 Chris 我们的 Modern 那个 Modern Civilization 的话，我想从马哈亚那的这个角度来看的话，就是比较难，就是从空性的这个立场来做。他刚才是讲到 give， 我是 give 你这个布施这个角度去说，那是六度中的前面一度，从布施直接融进禅定之后，要到智慧，前面的五度还是要后面的智慧般若这个来做引导。所以今天我们面对的所有这样的所有人类的这些问题，这些很流行的问题，我们 environment 这个问题，其实从佛法的角度去看的，就是我们要用我们这样的智慧，我们 wisdom， 用我们翻译是 wisdom， 我们用梵语就是 prajna， 用我们的般若空性、般若智慧去看待这个。那看待这个所谓的般若智慧的空性是怎么样？就是一己一理啊。用我们的话讲，就是用出世的精神做入世的事业，你也不能够去面对它。但到最后就是要，他刚才用的那个贪嗔痴对比界定的这个也很有趣，但是有一些用的是翻错的。那个戒你是翻 virtue， 那个是错的，那个是 precept， 还有你那个定用八也是不对，应该是因为你后面的下面的解释是那一个concentration 是还 OK 的，所以有一些英文的翻译是跟佛法一般还是不太对。所以这个以后可以慢慢修，因为其实佛法很难的。所以我们今天人间佛教研究中心，因为是人间佛教，我们一直要去推这个 private Buddhism 的问题，就是这样。我们很难去找到这一些我刚才前面讲到 disciplinary 这种跨学科的这样的一个学者。我们中心未来要推的就是那一种佛教管理思想。我们未来也有这个南京的这个牛首山的一个这个副总裁，他也是南京牛首山的那个吴勇，知道吗？有这个研究中心，他是研究佛学，又是研究经济管理。像我们上一次的请那个黄国清跟那个选另外那个郑振华教授，像这种跨学科的学者很难的，很难找的。所以我们一直希望能够找这方面的学者来讲。像今天我们的 Dr. Bennett， 他因为是水的专家，那所以从水的角度去看这个佛法怎么样去运用。所以后面他那个很有趣，我觉得后面他那个部分很有趣。我看时间也差不多了，我做这样一点的补充了。因为你刚才问到那个问题，其实这是一个大问题，但是人类一直在寻找这样一个 solution。 那其实当然我们都觉得自己的方法是最好的，但是不见得，对不对？科学有科学的方法，佛教有佛教方法，其他基督有基督教他们自己的说法。但总而言之，大家都提出自己的看法嘛，然后再来对话，然后再来反正就是为人类解决嘛。所以他后面提到要那个 什么 kindness 要 loving， 对不对？其实我们只讲 compassion 用智慧 compassion 跟 wisdom 跟智慧，就是悲智、慈悲跟智慧。所以我们对众生是要 compassion 的，我们不会用 loved 的是一般的，当时就会被大众化去讲，在佛法里面不会用 loved， 我们会用 compassion。Kindness 我们会用，因为 love 会一般会陷入到一般的没有很好的界定的话，会陷入到一般的 selfish 那个地方去，私爱、自私的那个角度去了。所以佛法其实不会用爱这个字眼，他会用在爱的字眼，它是不好的，不好的，它是不好的。比如说六处皆六入处，然后就产生受、爱、取、有、生老病死这样，所以那个爱一产生爱就会取有，那个就不好。那修行不可以在爱这里，要在前面受跟出这个前面就要把它，这个以后有机会再跟各位分享一下。那个一受一接受的，我们就看那个觉知它，如实的去觉知它。好，当现在你现在听这个演讲，不管怎么样，你就觉知它，感觉它的感觉，这样就对了。这就是受，修在这里修。没有任何效果办法，但你不是枯木死灰，你还是在觉知，那么这样才能够进入定，进入到定的时候才会产生慧。我们要的是智慧，有智慧才能够观照。定是一个前行，要修行这个定。所以刚才讲到做 mindfulness， 他每天在磕头啊，他在拜佛，他要拜十万拜，拜完了没？快拜完了吗？一拜
要需要三年的，差不多了。
对，你去拜。这个是对自己一个折服我关心啊，每天这样子拜，这样拜，他就是这样很虔诚的这样子拜。那在拜的过程当中，你其实也是可以产生定的，产生定的，啊，对，所以那个定呢，那个 mindfulness 那个其实也可以用 samadhi， 佛法讲的三昧，samadhi 这样子。对，好的，那么时间上的关系，不知道各位还没有问题，没有吗？啊，好，那我们还是有一个那个感谢函，我们这赠送给我们的 Dr. Bennett， 请各位掌声一下。谢谢。